Hi, I'm KB. Are you sure all the fans in your computer are spinning as they should right now? And what happens if one of them dies or gets disconnected without you noticing? Today we're going to take a look at monitoring computer fans. I'm going to show you how you can set up monitoring and notifications in Aqua Computer's Aqua Suite. But the same principles can be applied to other fan controllers if they offer the same capabilities. And just to get it out of the way, this video is not sponsored by anyone. I've paid for all the products I'm using and showing myself. Your fans are driven by an electrical motor, and although they are very unlikely to fail by themselves, it can happen. It's just more likely that a cable gets disconnected while you move your computer, or you pull the cables when you install equipment inside the case. Or perhaps a cable is pressed against the fan, preventing it from spinning. So, what would happen if one of your fans suddenly stops spinning? Well, it depends. If it's a single fan cooling a critical component like the CPU, that component will get hot and reduce its own performance to prevent overheating, a process called thermal throttling. It might even shut down to protect itself. In the worst case, the component might get damaged or completely fail. If you have several fans that share a job, like taking care of the airflow through the case, or cooling a radiator used for water cooling, the still working fans would have to spin faster to maintain proper cooling, and that would increase the noise produced by your computer. So you're looking at increased noise, poor performance, and possibly hardware failure. Let's take a look at my PC. Even though a computer has a glass side panel like mine, which I have removed to make this video, it might still have fans at places where they are hard or impossible to see during normal operation, like under a radiator or on the back, like I have on my side radiator. And unless I look at a weird angle, I cannot see the fans at the top of my case. Your case could have solid side panels or be under your desk, making it even harder to spot a failed fan. If you have many fans in your case, you might have several fans connected to one fan header with a fan hub or a cable splitter like this one. The problem with that is that the RPM signal from only one of the fans is connected back to the fan header. So if you are monitoring this signal, like we will be doing later, you will only be notified if that one connected fan is the one failing, and you won't be alerted if the other fails. You can check part 2 of this series for a solution on how to monitor multiple fans connected to a single fan header. In this video, we will concentrate on the case where you have a single fan connected directly to a fan header. In my PC, I have 3 fans on the bottom radiator connected together. The 2 fans behind the side radiator are paired, and so are the 2 fans at the top. But the fan at the back of my case is connected directly to a fan header, so we'll go through with setting up monitoring and notifications for that. As I mentioned, I'm using AquaSuite from Aqua Computer together with one of their excellent fan controllers, the Opto, plus an older Aqua Era controller. Even though the company has Aqua in their name, their controllers work just as fine in air-cooled systems. Let's take a look at the management and monitoring software, AquaSuite. The Aqua Computer devices do have built-in alarms that you can trigger in case of a failure. Let's take a look at the Opto controller under alarms. You see here you can activate it for each of the fans that you want to monitor. And if you have a special cable, it's listed here, you can use it to simulate a press to the power button to turn off the computer entirely. That is very good in case of catastrophic failures like the water pump failing in a water cool system, but it is a bit much in our case. The older Aqua Era controller here do have more options, like sounding a buzzer or executing a script. But for the alarms, we can monitor the fans. I'll try to add a fan here. And it do seem that the alarm is raised when there are no RPM signal for a period in time. And if you do have fans that you turn off when cooling is not needed, you might get false alarms here. So let's go to the playground and build our own solution. Under the section Notifications, I'll add a new notification.
As you can see here in the actions menu, we do have quite many options to choose from. Making sound pop-ups. You can even send an email or post to Twitter. We'll just add a standard Windows notification. Let's say it's a warning. And we just want the normal Windows beep. I'll add a title to the notification. Like so, and a descriptive message. I'll add a little delay to the notifications just to filter out if there are small fluctuations that might trigger. And I'll repeat the notifications after half an hour, just in case I miss it. Let's save our notification for now. The notification needs a trigger. That's a Boolean value, true or false, that tells it when to activate. Next, I'll build some logic that checks the fan. I'll make a virtual software sensor to keep the notification section free from too much clutter. So we go to virtual software sensor. And we'll add a new one. I'll call it a failed back fan. Because it should output true in case the fan has failed and false otherwise. I'll just keep the unit blank as AquaSuite don't have a Boolean value. Like so. We'll need an input value. I'll just select the fan speed because that's what we want to monitor. It's a data source. And it's connected to the octo. Back fan, the fan speed. I do have a habit of putting the prefix in parentheses here in the name. Just makes it easier to build more complex logic. We do have an option to put in a test value. Let's say 0. So if you want to test our sensor, we can activate the test and let it output 0 for 5 seconds. Like so. Like many programming languages, AquaSuite uses a numeric value for true and false. If the value is 0, it means false, and if the value is 1, it means true. We do want our sensor to output true, that is the value 1, if the fan has stopped, that is when RPM is 0, and false, that is the value 0, when the fan is spinning, that is when the RPM is not 0. So we'll simply use a logic function called not that reverses the Boolean value it receives. I'll add it here. It's a logic function and choose the not. I connect the output from our sensor to the input of the logic function and the output from the logic function to the virtual sensor output. Like so. I'll add a little description to the logic functions so we can see what it's doing. Is it stopped? So we can see now the fan is spinning. The value is greater than 0, so it outputs 0. And the back fan has not failed. To activate the test function, for the input, we can press a little arrow in the corner here, and it'll go to the value 0 that we put into the sensor. 0, and it gets reverted, and it outputs 1, to indicate that the fan has failed.
But hold on, you might say. What if the fan is not spinning because the fan controller told it to stop? For instance, if cooling is not needed and you want to reduce noise. And you're absolutely right. So we'll add a check for this situation to our sensor to avoid false notification.
I'll add another data source. And I'll select the fan power. Fans, back fan, power. As that value is how fast the controller is telling the fan to spin. And it's measured in percentage of maximum speed. I'll call it power in percent. And for the test value, I'll write 0 to simulate that the controller wants the fan to stop. Most fans stop below a certain percentage, so we'll just add a check to see if the fan power is below that threshold. I know that my fan stops at around 12%. Little description. And we'll do a check to see if the power is above or below that. So add another logic function. See if it's greater than the threshold. I'll connect the output to the input. So this function now returns if the fan is supposed to be spinning. Like so. We see that the input power is 15%. It's above the threshold, meaning that the fan is supposed to be spinning. It's outputting true, or the value 1. Try to test 0. It's below the threshold. Should it spin? No, it should not. Now our virtual sensor should only output true if both the conditions, is it stopped and should it spin, are true, or in other words, they are both 1. And we'll just take a shortcut and simply multiply the two values. Use a function, multiply. Connect that to the output. Now, if they are both true or 1, we multiply 1 by 1 and we get 1. If either is 0, the output is 0, meaning true. Oh, sorry, false. So, do a little test. We do have power to the fan. It is spinning. Hello, fail fan. If it suddenly stops spinning, both are 1 and we output a fail fan. Indication here, if the power is 0 and the fan is not spinning, it's good. Output is false. So the sensor works as expected. Let's go back to the notification and add our virtual software sensor as an input. And select the data source. Find the virtual software sensors here. I have my failed back fan. I'll add a name for the sensor. And we can put a test value if you want to test the notification. Have to make the duration larger than our value you put in before. And just connect the two. And to the notification, We'll also add the data source. It makes it a little bit easier to see which software sensor has failed in case we should add more to the theme notification. So
we are all done now. I'll risk my finger by sticking it in the running fan to stop it, and we'll hopefully see a nice notification popping up to tell us that there's a problem with the fan. Isn't that just beautiful? I'll encourage you to play around in the playground. You can make some really interesting things. As I mentioned, in the second part of this series, we'll dive deeper into how you can monitor multiple fans connected to the same fan header. That will involve some mathematical gymnastics in the playground, so stay tuned for that. For now, be happy and have fun.